Hi friends, welcome back to my channel, and in this video we're going to see about Nippon Life India Asset Management Company, or basically Nippon Life Asset Management Company or NAM Limited. So all these three basic names has come to this company, but basically you should know whether to buy this kind of stocks at its current price, because you should note guys, friends, insurance companies as well as AMC companies, for example HDFC AMC, Nippon Life Asset Management AMC, has run so much in this period of time, because you should know there has been a strong fundamental outlook by this share. But you should know, apart from all this outlook, the main problem hiding in the share is because of the overvaluation. This overvaluation has come because of the amount of profit this company is trying to increase, and also you should know the various tradings that has been done by this company, and also various companies that have been doing this. So basically, before going to this company, let us see what are the different types of AMCs dealing with it, and in which place Nippon Life India Assessment Company Limited is being situated. So before going to this video fully, friends, if you like this video and if you want more videos, click the subscribe button, because you could get our latest updates regarding many shares. And the first and foremost thing is that, as I already said, HDFC Management is, HDFC AMC is the first market leader in this company, and it's having a share price of 3380 rupees. But if you note that Nippon Life India is coming second place, and it is very very good to know it. But the main problem in these companies and this type of companies is that the basic things you should know. The reason is because the profit has been increased, and I am accepting it, but the valuation you're giving for this is very very risky in nature. But we can see fully whether it's totally risky, or we can buy it now or sell it later. So let us go see about it. So basically we are going to see a 4 years of this revenue, profit, and also this loan exposure to this company. And let us see this fully, friends. And first and foremost, we see this, the revenue has constantly increased from 955 crores up to 1600 crores, and it's very very important point to note. And also the EBITDA margin annually has been from increase in this with the region of 41% to 43%, and it's very very good point to note. But the profit increase, 487 crores, 457 crores, 402 crores yearly comparison, we see there's a good thing you should note. But you should note a main point is that the EP has been constant in the range of 6.8 to 7.9, and there has been a good improvement in this EPS. So basically, let us go and see the balance sheet of this company, because we want to know what are the basic balance sheet things this company is having. So the total long term other term liability is only 54 crores, and also you should note that the current liability is the main note, trade payable is of 47 crores. And it has been reduced from 108 crore to 47 crores. It's a very, very good point to note. But coming down, all we can see the contingent liabilities and commitments as 33 crore. And it is very, very important point to note, because contingent liability may acquire or may not acquire. So that is a main point to note. So after all, seeing this short fundamental, notice the financial ratios of this company. So why financial ratios is very, very important for a company? Because whenever once we are going to invest for a long term, this company want to know how has the share performed in this last 5 or 6 years, and what are the key financial ratios in order to determine what can be the risk in the future. So basically we can see, friends, the book value has jumped from 39 rupees to 42 rupees in this year, and you can see 1500 rupees or 1600 rupees as the book value. This is because before the share issuing in the market, that was been holding by the Reliance Capital as well as this Nippon Life. It was a JV, but it got finally split up, and I will tell this news also later in the shareholding segment. And the first thing you should note in is the ROCE, return on capital employed, is nothing but ROCE. It has been in the constant range of 30% to 26%, so it has fallen down 4%, but I think they can definitely improve. So let us see the profitability ratios. The EBITDA, EBIT, earnings before depreciation, interest and tax, has been increased from 41% to 48%, and that is very very good thing to note. Compared with the valuation ratios, if you see, friends, it is normally the company is having an enterprise value of 12,000 crore, and that is very very good point to note, because 12,000 crores is nothing but if you see around $1.8 billion is the amount of market cap this company is having currently now. But if you want to see the basic things, the book value of the share is 42 rupees and the share price is around 441 rupees. Which means it is trading to its book times of 10.5 to times its book value. But if you see the given below industry median, because if you see HDFC AMC is trading the range of 23 times its book value. But if you see HDFC AMC as other, that is a lot of exposure to it if you compare to Nippon Asset Management. And also the last we are going to see is about the shareholding pattern of this company. Because shareholding pattern, we want to see to know the any good buyers are buying the share or not. So the first and foremost thing, if you note that the promoter is holding 75% of this company, in which Nippon Life holding 75% and Reliance Capital Limited is holding around 0.93%. This is what the first is said, that was a JV and that got finally split up, and Nippon Life Insurance Company is finally holding this company. And also you should know the institutional holdings, who are the big players they have invested. HDFC Trustee Company has invested around 99 lakh shares in this company. Doron Emergency Markets has around 85 lakhs in this company. And also one insurance company has invested. And let us see, any banks have invested. Banks have invested, but they have reduced their stake in this company. And also the final and foremost thing you should note in this company is that the price at which can one buy, or price which should one should buy and which one should sell. If you ask me, friends, I think it's very, very difficult for one to tell, because the main reason in this companies are earning, because this company is try to reduce its problems and increase their profit. But how much long this company can go this? Because when you think it is a safe event, there will be a downfall. But if you see HDFC AMC and this all types of this AMC, Nippon Life Management, if you see, they are trying to give their potential back in various ways, and it has definitely has a future hope. Now, according to the situation, I think I would not rather wait for a long term. Definitely, I would trade in the short term. So, after sharing the short term, people ask me, our friends ask me, what can be the buying range? If you ask me, friends, I think every correction or every dip can be a buying opportunity in order to trade from short term. For example, I can give you example, India will housing finance. Whenever there's a correction, people buy, and whenever there's a positive news, the share goes up, people exit and come down again. Come down again and buy and also exit. So the basic concept in this, if it goes around 400 rupees, I mean Nippon Life goes around 400 rupees or 380 rupees. From 380 rupees to 412 rupees, that would be the buying range, and I would be seeing a target of 475 in this share. So people may ask the second question, what if Nippon Life as a financial is not come to that rupee? Or can I buy now? If you ask me, can I buy the 441 range? If people ask me, if you can take this, you can definitely buy, having a long term hope. Who knows, it can be the next PVR also, because PVR has jumped from the range of 440 to 2000 rupees now. But it is just a price comparison, not a fundamental comparison. But Nippon Life Management has a good potentiality, because when this market is down a lot, the share is showing a momentum. Then think about when the market is going to boom, and since it is going to boom, these AMC companies have a bright future, because investment do not end within a short period of time. Investment carry on. And also when it is a foreign collaboration for Nippon Life India Management versus the HDFC AMC Management, it comes when valuation principle also, when the price principle also, people like to acquire Nippon Life Asset Management, because people think that Nippon Life Asset Management could go till this HDFC AMC Management company, like, because both are the same concept, both are the same fundamental, both are looking the same principle, but the valuation of HDFC AMC is very, very high when compared to Nippon Life India Asset Management Company. So if you compare the valuation concept, I would definitely acquire Nippon Life Asset Management Company, friends. And you should note a main point in Nippon Life India Asset Management finally is that whenever people have a specific news about this AMC companies, they are trying to increase it. But when we see a main point, you should note that the amount of operational revenue and as well as the EBITDA margin this company is trying to earn is very, very good, because they don't have that much of operating costs or operating efficiencies, only have their employee costs, because the main thing involves around investing and also earning a lot. And also you should note that these four companies are the main companies involved here: Nippon Life India Asset Management, HDFC Management, ILSF and Shriram Transport. Now why you can say me, people, then how high said this company is overvalued, HDFC is overvalued? Because the times to study book value is very, very over. And if any correction comes, I think the major correction can be seen in the HDFC management, because you should note a main point here is that the promoter holdings has been same in this company, and also the book value of this company, as I already told, the book value of this company is around 144 rupees currently. Nobody is trading at the times of around 23 times or 24 times its book value, where rather Nippon Life is saying around only 10 times its book value, and it is a very very good news for Nippon Life India Asset Management Company. So finally, what price to buy? 380 to 415. Wait for a target of 475. So people who are already holding, you may see a target of 463 to 475 rupees. That would be the better price for a short term trader. For a long term trader, you can definitely hold if you have bought at lower levels, because when this market is going to trend over very very good, Nippon Life India Asset Management Limited can definitely give you a lot of return hopes to you, friends. Thank you, friends. If you like this video, then make sure you can subscribe button, because you could get the latest updates regarding many shares very very soon.